perfect match. Author: Ramendra Kumar. Illustrator: Niloufer Wadia. The Jalebis are the best, Dadaji said, his whiskers bristling. No way. They are no match for my Halwas, Dadiji replied, her nose twitching like an inquisitive rabbit's. Dadaji was a tall, well-built man who carried his 65 years rather well. He had retired as a manager from a leading bank. Dadiji was of medium height, thin, but with the energy of a beehive. She had been a school principal most of her life and treated almost everyone like an errant student. The two of them lived with their grandchildren, Sakshi and Saket. The kids played hockey in their campus regularly. An abandoned park had been divided into two fields, one for the boys, Dadiji's Halwas, and the other for the girls, Dadaji's Jalebis. Dadaji was a diabetic and kept fantasizing about sweets which he was forbidden to eat. He had named the teams after his favorite dishes, and the names had become an instant hit. Dadiji smiled a radiant smile and then, quickly rearranging her features, said, "So, the Halwas are scared of a bunch of snooty and stuck-up girls, is it? You feel they are going to make actual Halwa out of you?" "Of course not," the boys chorused. "We can play them anytime, anywhere," Narendra said. "Bring them on," Dadi yelled, Rajesh, flexing his non-existent muscles. "Did I hear you right, Dadaji? You want us to play with the Halwas?" Jitika, the vice captain of the Jalebis, asked, her hands on her hips. The stage was set for the epic battle between the Halwas and Jalebis. Dadiji, who had represented her college in hockey, taught the Halwas a few more skills. Dadaji, who had studied management, brought his team building and planning talents to the fore. Dadaji used to go for a walk in the park every morning with more than a dozen of his friends. Dadiji had attended dance classes where she had learned contemporary dance with 20 others. The two mentors had invited their friends and dance mates to cheer their teams. Besides, the parents and some of the teachers were also in attendance to watch this clash of the titans. Even the peanut vendor and the ice cream seller who sold their wares in the market had shifted to the venue of the mother of all matches. The ball was with Rihanna, and as she passed the ball to Jitika, a dark shape suddenly streaked across the field. It was Tufan, Sakshi and Saket's pet dog. He was short and sturdy, and was the fastest thing on four legs in the vicinity. He loved playing ball, but for the last week he had been denied any access to it. Every time he tried going near it, either Sakshi or Saket had hurled instructions to the contrary. He had been waiting in the wings patiently, looking ever so longingly at the white, round piece of fun. Now suddenly it was within reach and he made a dash for it, grabbed it in his mouth and disappeared into the bushes around the hockey field. He kept moving, crossing the adjoining park where Dadaji walked, the place where Dadiji danced, and straight to the spot where he knew his best friend, Andy, would be waiting for him. Meanwhile, the Halwas and Jalebis dropped their hockey sticks and ran after Tufan. They looked for him in the bushes, behind trees, under benches, inside dustbins, between legs and everywhere else they could. And I am going to host a feast for them. We can have a picnic tomorrow on this very ground, added Dadiji. The announcements were greeted with hoots and yells. Forgetting their animosity and rivalry, the Halwas and Jalebis indulged in high fives. But Dadaji, if both our teams are winners, who is the man of the match? We do not have a man of the match, but we do have a champ of the match, and he is none other than the canny canine Tufan. He gets my vote for providing a perfect ending to a perfect match, Dadaji said, and everyone laughed.